Same. If FaZe win this, they get in the playoffs.
Well, see, it'd be like, if it stays the way it is, we Elevate, Envy, Units, E6, Midnight, EG, LG, UYU.
I would just have to see how the matchup.
The only, I guess I'd say probably LG, E6. If I had to pick right now.
But yeah, it depends on the bracket.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it might not even be possible. Yeah, it might not even be possible. You're right. Because, oh, yeah, well, it definitely might not be because of where E6 is. Like, they've been one of the better teams, but they're sitting at what, dead last within the actual division. So
you'd probably play, if you're 5th A, you'll probably play 8th B round one. That's the way I'm imagining it.
E6 is going to have the damn gauntlet. they're gonna make a run. Some progress on both points, though, within this map 3-4 Enigma6. And they just want to push up, try to get maybe some spawn kills. One player off spawn is going to be Zuma, who's just hiding back here, knowing
so
they're
you don't
coming
see
hunting
me.
For
I'm not here. I'm not back here, I promise. All right, I'm back here. Maybe I am. And, well, they're going to fly in him. Try to get that spawn kill. They're able to find it as well. Now we're zooming in to spawn, probably with his teammates.
Yep, all the way back. Elba. Oh, my God. He gets caught again. This is not a fun sequence for Zuma. He's going to spawn in the back again, and you've got GuideRx already having him lined up. Poor Zuma just being toyed with, basically unable to play within this round. You still got 2 minutes to work with, a 6-life advantage. Scraps now back off spawn to help him out. Zuma finally able to get a little bit of revenge and get out of his base, but a nice sequence there from E6 is going to allow them to get a hefty life advantage, get back into the point, try to work on some progression.
I mean, if GuideRx is going to play those spawns and not push up with his team in those pipes, he has to find a kill or two. Like, he has to. Like, he's literally holding off the phase reinforcements, and that doesn't happen. So, a bit of a greedy play doesn't go E6's way, and that push afterwards gets shut down. But a lot of time to work with, a 4-life advantage. They just have to try to slow down the clock a little bit, see if they can get on this point, contest it a little bit. Kismet says no trophy for you, FaZe.
Trophy
out.
He's
gonna be the first one in.
But they still need this break. Selium doing an excellent job at the elbow on the E6 side of the map. Him and Zuma able to combo to split this push once again. The E6 life advantage, which was what, it's 6 at the most, now down to 1. A nice battle back in from FaZe Clan and dealing with a very tough spot E6 tried to put him in. Now E6 setting up this next push, and you can see they've sent, what, 2 all the way towards the FaZe spawn. They're actually a 4 now. They're trying to really hit this from the back. Will FaZe be ready for this? They've got 2 ICRs on both sides of elbow. Fantastic job from FaZe. Oh my God, Asim, once again, a little bit of snap-a-doodle-do as he picks up 2. Life advantage now FaZe as the clock dwindling for E6. 20 seconds left for them to try to get in.
I mean, they wasted so much time setting up these last couple of pushes where it's down to 15 seconds. And now they have to hurry and have to run into FaZe, but they do trade well. Trade effectively, but it's 0 top middle with that ICR. Can he find a second?
That can't happen.
No, it cannot, Clint, as GuideRx gets shut down. And it just feels like these clutch gunfight moments right now are going the way of FaZe. Think about the search and destroy. It was Asim in a couple of rounds. You see Asim getting hyped up right now.
I like Asim a lot too, man. Yeah. I played a little bit of Blackout with him, talked to him. You know, sometimes throughout the Pro League, I don't know. Just seems like good head on his shoulders, just excited
well, it's a good
to be
bounce
here.
I think game 2, because at one point in game 1, he was like 9-20. Like, didn't have the best game number 1.
And now, I mean, they're on the brink of doing kind of what 100 Thieves did. You know, you take a tough loss, you come in, remind people, we are a top team. If they can get a 3-0 here over a solid.
This just reminds me, though, of like a Pro League Enigma6 loss. Like, you lose by 20 points in a hard point, around 11. Yeah. Like, it's the little mistakes, and that's what we talked about for so long. They would go game 5 and they would lose, and then Anaheim, they got top 6, right?
Yeah.
So, like,
to be fair,
they're playing them tough.
Yes, you are seeing that it is a series where E6, they could be FaZe.
Yeah.
Yes, 100%. So, that is there, but loss still hurts. I think the big thing, though, is you would like Mayhem saying, if they lose, not that big of a deal. Yeah, I get that, but you'd like to see more maps at least. Like, get this to a map 4, get this to a map 5, get the repetitions. We were talking about that yesterday with teams like Splice.
Yeah, EG.
Yeah, I was trying to think of the other one, but yeah, EG.
Yeah, EG units, you know, they play each other nice. Two teams that more work, the better. Scraps now, 25 off the streaks. Him and his European duo, 0. Mine for 7 in a row, not right now, make it 8. As he's 200 points away. Trying to put this match away with some streaks. They'd be able to do it if they can win this offensive round, be up 2-0, go to defense, use those streaks, and see you later, E6, but we'll see if they can execute.
I see him off through the window. Scraps patrolling bottom mid, should have a free kill. He's going to catch him, and there's the streaks. Nice patience to pick him up, and now Zero, a chance to get streaks as well. Able to snap and connect. He's on an island, just slides away. Nice, oh, I was going to say, nice job trying to finesse. Maybe he can get the streaks, but not quite able to do it. Scraps
so
just wants to
down the push,
guarantee
yep.
the round. Just wants to guarantee the round when...
Well, and he's making sure they can't push through this elbow street. That's all that is.
Guaranteed the win. Guaranteed the win.
They found two kills in the Hellstorm as well.
I would have loved for them to hold them for the next round, but like that's just... You knew you got the round win. Zero went on a bit of a tear through the mid-game of that round. He was doing with the ICR, the Maddox, the SOG.
Well, he's done that this year. He was on the old red team. He was a Maddox, a SOG. Finally, we've been able to see him in his natural role with that main AR on FaZe.
I don't even know what his natural role is.
I would say main AR.
Everything.
I would say main AR. That's when we see him at his best, so I'm going to say that.
Okay, all right. He's a man of many talents.
Sure.
FaZe, can they secure this final round? Get the 3-0. God or exit has been, God, like hard carry form for this E6 team. Started out 3-9. Gets a frag grenade kill to start things out, but doesn't last long after that. Every FaZe player we hop to seems to have a chance to get streaks. First it was Scraps, then it was Zero, now it's a Seam. The Seam will get cut short. Scraps' streak is still going, by the way. He's 10-3. He's got 7 in a row.
It's always interesting in control when you have a fast round like we had in round number 2. Not only do you have the round advantage, but the opponents, they don't have a chance to get back in the game with specialists, right? So you have that advantage. You take the momentum, plus you get those specialists early. They use the grav slam. They have the war machine. A lot of the times, there's two rounds where they can find it.
I think Scraps is close to wrapping now. He's on the same streak. He's only 190 off, getting some more. We'll see where he maybe opts to use lighting. He's going to go ahead and do it.
Just going to ping, keep him off of it.
Does he end up pulling this in?
It's a scare tactic.
He's so close to picking up more. Two drop for FaZe Clan. A chance for E6. The lightning right in behind it. Scrap streak now into double digits. He's got 10 in a row. It's going to be... E6 on the point. They haven't been able to quite finish it yet. Scraps just needs 170. One player just wrapped right below him. Reads him like a book. Now 45 off the rewrap. And here comes the war machine. Connects more streaks for him. 12 in a row. 15-3. You might still get the point if you're E6, but there's not a ton of time left. We'll get the extra minute, obviously. But you've got a lightning. Now you've got another Hellstorm to work with. No one can shut him down. No one can show. Oh my God. I thought he was going to get another. The streak ends at what? 14. 17-4. Insanity from Scraps.
Well, now you have these two streaks to just put this round away. As soon as E6 sort of gets on the point and find a kill or two, he's going to ping it, get all that information for his team. Hey, General, I saw you on my laptop. That's going to be a kill. Got a rest, not ready for it. Now a 3-life advantage, 1 minute to work with if you're E6. And we saw what they tried to do in round 1. They just tried to work spawn kills as much as they could. Really worked that flank. Now let's see, they're going to go top middle. Try to get on this point as fast as they can.
Prezi flies over the top. The trade's just about even, but you'll keep that if you're FaZe, as you have the life advantage. Now he calls the streaks in as they come off spawn. Picks up one, wants to keep delaying this as much as he can. He's going to call in the second streak now. Just make sure they can't get any kind of foothold in this. Three players left for E6. Kismet, Brezzy, Mayhem. The world to do. Brezzy, the guy with a chance to do something special. What are you expecting there? He doesn't spot him. He's somehow able to stay up. He's got to find a chance to use this grab slam. Going to go ahead and go through, but it's just going to find one. 6v3. Big advantage to FaZe. The final moments of this series. Kismet can't pull it off. FaZe Clan get the 3-0. A solid win over a tough team in E6. But a 3-0. You got to feel very, very good about that if you're a FaZe fan, considering how yesterday went.